Eskaters, Nate from Eskate Hub here, and today I've got my review of the BKB DIY Electric Skateboard Kit. BKB is an acronym for Build Kit Boards, and they've been selling DIY Eskate parts on their website for a few years now, and this is actually their first kit that they've put together. So when they ship it to you, it all comes in pieces and you get to build the thing yourself. I've already done a tutorial video on how to build this electric skateboard, so if you want to see all the inside parts and the electronics of it, head over there and check it out. The link is in the description. This is going to be a video of the finished product, how it rides, all of the specs, and all of the tests that I usually do. So the deck on the BKB electric skateboard is 31 inches long and 9.5 inches wide. Because of the length to width ratio, it feels like a massive platform to stand on, which is comforting. It's really stiff, there's zero flex in it whatsoever, which is kind of expected on a shortboard because it still needs to house all of the electronics underneath, so any flex would cause some serious issues to the enclosure. It has a concave deck and slightly raised shoulders above the wheels. So these do two things. They create more space between the wheels and the deck to reduce the risk of getting wheel bite, and they give your feet more leverage to make turning easier. There is a little bit of a kick tail, which is great for tic-tacking around even tighter corners, dropping off curbs, doing some manuals, but it's probably not big enough to do any real tricks with it. The grip tape is nice and coarse. It comes in these hexagonal pieces. You don't get enough to cover the entire deck, so make sure you get creative and put them in the most important places. As you can see, the top of the deck is red, the bottom is completely black. Red's not for everybody, but I think it looks really cool with the contrast between the grip tape and with those red wheels. The wheels are 97mm 78A, which on a shortboard feel huge. It kind of feels like you're standing really high off the ground, but you're not really. It's the same height as most longboards with the same size wheels. Again, that's just the short deck that makes you feel like that. They are a little bit spongy, but not quite as much as I would have liked. When you're riding, you feel everything that comes off the ground, all of the vibrations, but that's not really unique to the BKB board. That's pretty much the same across all shortboards. It has 10-inch trucks with a wheelbase of 21 inches. This makes turning really easy, and you can hang a U-turn in the tightest of spots. And let's not forget that the kick tail helps assist with this too. The BKB electric skateboard has dual 6354 motors, which are incredibly powerful. You need to be a really experienced rider to go from standstill to full acceleration without falling off the back. It has a sharp low end curve which helps you to take off fast and get up to cruising speed in no time. And from there, it's a more gradual climb to the top speed. In my tests, I managed to hit a top speed of 29.5 miles per hour, which is 47.5 kilometers an hour. And that's a tad over what the specs say the BKB electric skateboard is capable of on their website. I had my sister help me out with the hill climb because it's really hard to film, so let's go back and watch that. All right, this is where we're gonna do the hill test. Come around, have a look. It's 21.2% incline and we're about halfway up the hill. My sister is going to be on the Meepo V1.5, so it's a fair few years old and it's hub motors. I'll be on the BKB with the dual belt motors. I'm definitely gonna run her off, but it'll be good fun. Let's go. So we're at the bottom of the hill. I hope you can see how steep that hill really is. I'll see you at the top. Got some power, that's for sure. 20% hill grade that was, and I wasn't even full throttle, so I've got no doubt that this thing will be able to do 30%, maybe something a little bit more, but needless to say, it's gonna do literally any hill that you throw at it. This thing completely destroys hills. I don't think you'll be able to find a slope that this board cannot handle. But once it gets down to 10% of its battery, it loses a lot of power and virtually cannot climb any hills. So make sure you keep that in mind if you've got any hills coming up towards the end of your ride. The battery is a 10S 3P array of 18650 30Q Samsung cells, which I think is quite massive for a shortboard. And you can really feel the weight in it. It's heavier than a lot of longboards I've ridden before, but it also has a bigger battery than most too. I did a range test along the Great Ocean Road, and if anyone knows it, it's really windy and has lots of up and downs. I weigh 83 kilos and I rode pretty hard. I actually hit my top speed on this ride, and I ended up getting a range of 13.18 miles, which is 21.22 kilometers. Now that's actually a bit lower than what they say the range is on their website. But remember, this is a DIY e-board and I had to put it together myself. So there is every chance that my ability to build this electric skateboard has adversely affected its range capabilities. I'm almost certain of it. I don't have the remote on me right now. I think I left it in the car, but take a look at this up close footage. The remote is really basic. There's no display. It's just a couple of buttons and some LED lights to indicate the battery level. I never knew what speed I was doing, which was a little bit worrying at the beginning, but then I realized that I should just ride at a comfortable pace anyway, and my ride became a lot more enjoyable. You do get haptic feedback from the remote as the board starts to near the end of its battery, but one thing I couldn't figure out was the speed modes. I don't actually think there is more than one mode, but if you do opt to get the Bluetooth receiver, you can play around with all those settings on the app, and if you're savvy enough, you can plug the ESC into the computer and play around with all the settings in there. The throttle is really responsive, so you need to focus on staying in control of that thumb wheel. Any movement on the throttle that is more than necessary, you will feel the feedback from the motors. And for inexperienced riders, this might cause you to lose a little bit of balance. The best approach here is to ease on and ease off the accelerator when you want to change speeds, whether going faster or slowing down. Now, I'm not saying this is a bad thing. There are a lot of riders that will love the amount of control they get with this ESC. The motors are just as strong at braking as they are accelerating. So if you're not ready and braced for it, you'll be on your ass before you can say build kit boards, DIY electric skateboard kit. So here's an aerial view of me applying the brakes. I come in from the right hand side, doing a pace a little bit faster than cruising speed, and I apply the brakes just about here. The first time I did it, I slammed on the brakes and they locked up and I skidded quite a bit, almost losing control. The second time round, I applied the brakes in a more controlled manner and I found that I came to a stop much faster and safer. Overall, the BKB DIY Electric Skateboard is a great project that produces you a solid e-board that you can either ride as it is or continue to tinker with to turn it into something that is truly unique to you. Everything is modular, so you can literally change out any component or part that you don't like with something that is more fitting to your riding style. I think it really is the perfect place to start if you're wanting to get into the DIY e-skate scene, but are feeling a little bit overwhelmed by everything that you need to know in order to build an electric skateboard. The price of the dual motor version of the BKB electric skateboard, which is this one, is $800 US. And there is also an option to get a single motor version, which is only $600. If I've helped you make the decision to buy the BKB DIY Eskate kit, then that's awesome, I've done my job. If you want to thank me, the best thing you can do is make your purchase through the link in my description. If you do, BKB pays me a tiny bit of money to say thanks for recommending their great products to you. And I want to say thank you to you for supporting this channel and helping me bring awesome Eskate content to new and aspiring Eskaters. If I've happened to miss anything and you've got a question, please ask in the comments below. I will answer it for you. And please like, subscribe, share with your friends, post it on Facebook, all that good stuff. It really does help out with the growth of this channel, which means more Eskate content for you, and I get to keep making Eskate reviews. All right, Eskaters, ride safe out there, and I'll see you soon.